الظن إن بعض الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه واتقوا الله إن الله تواب رحيم. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, last few Jumas we talked about the diseases of tongue. We talked about al-kadib wa al-namima previously. Today, inshallah, we will talk about the third disease of tongue, which is spread among the Muslim community, among the Muslim men and women. Family members, when they get together, they will start backbiting people. Friends, when they get together, they backbiting people. Anywhere, Muslims, brothers and sisters are in their gathering, they are using their tongues, which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala stopped us to use in that. Illa mashallah. Of course, we do have brothers and sisters, which is pious, have a fear from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, learning Quran and Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they are acting upon it. Brothers and sisters, what is backbiting? What is the definition of backbiting? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told to his companions, do you know what is akhiba, backbiting? They replied, Allah and His Messenger knows the best. Then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he replied and told, ذِكْرُكَ أَخَاكَ بِمَا يَكْرَهُ. You mention about something about your brother which he or she doesn't like people to know about it. SubhanAllah. Your Muslim brother or sister have shortcoming. They have done sin, but for no reason, just to talk and pass the message to others, you sit and talk with your friends and family, and you mentioning the shortcoming of other people without any benefit. That's called al-ghiba, backbiting. Brothers and sisters, backbiting is a great sin. Is one of the great sin. SubhanAllah. If Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgive that to that person, SubhanAllah, in day of judgment, that is totally up to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Or Allah might send him to the hellfire for a time whatsoever Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wants him or her to be in the hellfire. Brothers and sisters, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned clearly in Quran al-Kareem, O believers, keep yourself away from negative thoughts, dhan, upon your Muslim brother and sister, and don't be from those who hiding and listening to the conversation of his brother and sister, and afterward pass it to others. And وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا. Don't backbite some of you, some others. What will be the example of that? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he explained it to us by his word, أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا. If any one of you loves to eat the flesh of your brother, then to eat, definitely answer will be no, subhanAllah. Even an animal which is dead, none of the mankind loves to get closer to that. Even forget about eating that, subhanAllah. But how about flesh of your brother which passed away, subhanAllah, and you eat the flesh of that person, subhanAllah. In the end of ayah, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, Wattaqullah, fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. If you have one of these three things, you are doing, fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Fear of Allah will take you away from these bad habits. Inna Allah tawwab ar-Rahim. But the doors of repentance are open. And if you repent to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah will accept it from you inshaAllah. And He is so merciful. Brothers and sisters, in one hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, when I went up in Isra, in late night of Isra and Mi'raj, then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw some people, their nails made of metal, and they were scratching their faces in their chest. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, why are these people doing that? Why they are scratching their face and chest with the metal, nails of the metal? What is the punishment? Why they are punishing themselves? Then Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, he replied, هؤلاء الذين يأكلون لحوم الناس ويقعون في أعراضهم. Subhanallah. These were those people which they were backbiting others, subhanAllah. They were eating the flesh of other people, subhanAllah. If you backbite, you are eating flesh of your Muslim brother, subhanAllah. And the punishment hereafter, that you yourself, your head which you were looking after it in this dunya, you were looking after you looking after your hand in this dunya, the same hand, the same nails will be scratching your face in your chest, subhanAllah. Why? Because you did not control your tongue in this dunya, subhanAllah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was passing by one day with his companions, and there was an animal which was dead. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told, who can eat from this dead animal, subhanAllah. In one riwayah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he heard from two people, they were backbiting. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered those people, go down to that dead animal and eat from it. They said, Ya Rasulullah, how can we eat from that? That is unclean, that is not halal for a Muslim to eat. And you are telling us, don't eat haram. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told, a person who is backbiting his Muslim brother or sister is worse than this situation. Worse than a person who is eating the flesh of dead animal, subhanAllah. Also, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, one day he was talking with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she told, she didn't say anything to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just pointed to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She told Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Aisha radiallahu anha, she pointed only, she didn't use her tongue even. She was aiming that Safiya radiallahu ta'ala anha, she is really short, subhanAllah. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he got angry and told, the word you used, the word, that action you have done, if you put that one in a sea, subhanAllah, in a sea, in a ocean, that word will change the ocean, subhanAllah. Change the color of ocean. Change the taste of the ocean, subhanAllah. only one action, subhanAllah. But how about those brothers and sisters? They are sitting in a majlis for half an hour, 1 hour, 2 or 3 hours, more or less, and they talking about their Muslim brothers and sisters. They talking about the shortcoming of their brothers and sisters all the time. And with your brother, what will be the punishment of that person, subhanAllah, Malik? Also, Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah, one of the greatest ulama, one person came to him and told him, such a person, he was backbiting you. Then what he told him, okay, come, you take the plates of the dates. Take the plates of the dates and give it to that person. Take it to that person who backbited me. Then give it to him as a gift. When he took that plate of dates to him, then that person, he came to Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah. He told him, Ya Hasan al-Basri, I was backbiting you, and even though you didn't say anything against me, but even though you sent me a gift as well, of the gift of dates to me, then he told him, I have to do something to you as well. Because what you have done, when you were backbiting me, you were sending your good deeds, subhanAllah. The reward of fasting, reward of dhikr, reward of a prayer toward me. You gave me a lot of rewards of your good deeds, subhanAllah. You made me rich, subhanAllah. That's why I have to give you in return something. I have to give you something in return, which is a plate of the dates, subhanAllah. Brothers and sisters, worshipping, we are worshipping Allah. We come into the house of Allah, we pray with the Jama'ah, we pray Jumah, reading Quran Kareem, and don't believe from those who are muflis, subhanAllah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told to his companions, do you know who is muflis? Who is bankrupt? Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told, a person who doesn't have any sense, that is a muflis person. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told, muflis is a person which he coming in the day of judgment to the front of Allah with the mountain in huge rewards. He has a lot of rewards, but what's happening? Some people, he might harm someone, swear at someone, or did something wrong against Sharia. The good deed of that person will be transferred to that person, subhanAllah. In the end, he will be empty-handed, subhanAllah. Dear four brothers, the worship which we do, don't make automatically count for it, brother. Sister, don't make automatically count for it that if you do a good deed, then afterwards you backbiting, then your reward is going to your Muslim brother and Muslimah sister. When you see Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, when you stand before Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, you will be empty-handed. For example, brother, you have a lot of money in your account, but when you're going to shopping center, you buy a lot of things for yourself. Then when you use your card, there is nothing. Your transaction will be declined. Why? Because the credit which you had in your account already gone to someone else. SubhanAllah. Think how you feel in that time. How you will feel in that time. You will be very shameful in that time to that person. You build up huge things, but you don't have even cent in your account. Brothers and sisters, when you're going to Allah, be from those who have mountain and mountain of good deeds, inshaAllah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Mubarak, rahmatullahi alayhi, he says, if I was going to backbite someone, then I will backbite my parents. Why? Because my parents are the best people to get my rewards, none else, subhanAllah. Also, Imam Ghazali, rahmatullahi alayhi, he says, an example of a person who is backbiting is like a person who has manjanik. Manjanik is a kind of weapon which used previously in the field of battle. Then we will say nowadays, like a gun. A person who has a gun and he shoots the bullets to the right, to the left, in front, in the back. SubhanAllah, when you shoot the bullet, in the end there will be nothing left behind. Subhanallah. The same thing, a person who backbiting other person, like he is using the bullets which he has, in the end, he will be standing empty-handed. Also, we'll mention, what are the things which make you backbite? What are the things which make you backbite? Awwal, dhu'ful iman. A person who has a weak iman, a weak iman a person has, that person will backbite. Why? Because he is not acting upon the words of Allah, orders of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, in Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Secondly, who is backbiting? A person who is sitting with friends which are doing ma'asiyah, sin. They are away from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. When you sit with them, they will backbite and you will listen to them, subhanallah. And one day, 2 days, 3 days, after the third or fourth day, you will start doing the same thing, subhanallah. Also, jealousy. If you are jealous of someone, you will backbite that. Iblis, shaytan, become away from the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Why? Because he was jealous of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. How come Adam will make a azim sijda toward a person? Sijda to Allah, but toward a person which made from the clay, subhanallah. He become jealous of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Jealousy make him saying bad words about Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Also, khubbu dunya. If you love dunya, you will backbite a lot of people. You have a business. When a customer comes to your business, then you say, okay, he will tell you such a business, he's selling that good to me. He say, no, those people are lying. Those people, the goods are not good. Those people are this. You backbiting and saying a lot of things. Even though they have that qualities as well, that shortcoming, but you saying that is for dunya. You love dunya. That's why you backbiting. Also, al-farag, when you have a free time, subhanallah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam urged us, when you get use of your free time, when you free, remember Allah tabaraka ta'ala, worship of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. But unfortunately, some of our brothers and sisters, they are free, they don't have anything to do. Sit, call to someone and backbite, and sit with someone face to face and backbite. What is the ilaj? How we can sort out backbiting? How we can control our soul? First thing is taqwallahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. Fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Like Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned in the ayat of Surah Al-Hujurat, in wattaqullah, inna Allah tawwabur rahim, inna Allah tawwabur rahim. Fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah is the one who accepts repentance. He is most merciful. Be from those who fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يُكَفِّرْ عَنْهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِ وَيُعْظِمْ لَهُ أَجْرًا. Whoever has a fear from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive all his sin and Allah will give him a greater rewards. Also, what you do, you think about your shortcomings. Subhanallah. Brothers and sisters, we are not free of sin. Subhanallah. Every one of us, we have shortcoming. When you go into sleep before that, think about your shortcoming. How many shortcomings you have. When you think about yourself, then you will never talk about someone else. Also, count with yourself. Muhasabatul nafs. You count with yourself. How many good deeds you have done? What you have done today, in last week, in last month, in last year, when you count with yourself, then that will make you busy from the backbiting. Also, mudawamat al-dhikrillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. Remember Allah all the time. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was remembering Allah fi kulli ahyanihi. All the time he was remembering Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. When you remember Allah, you remember, you will be away from backbiting. Ibn Wahb rahmatullahi alayhi, he said, I had this habit, backbiting. But one day I told to myself, when I backbite, afterwards I have to fast. I made it nadhar upon me, compulsory upon me. Then I was backbiting, I was fasting the second day, the coming day. Then again and again and again I was backbiting because fasting was so easy for me. Then later on I told, if I backbite, then I have to give one dirham to a poor person. Then when I backbite, I gave 1 dirham or 2 dirham. Afterwards, dunya was really sweet to me. Dirhams, dollars were really sweet to me. After that, I left backbiting because of the dinar in dirham which I was giving away. This is the way, brothers. If you really want, subhanAllah, if you really want to stop backbiting, then Sheikh, make it nadhar upon you. If I do so, then I will pay $10, $20 afterwards. If you do it one day or two or three or 5 days, in the end, you will realize money is going from me. And reality, the most wealth which is going from you, that is your good deed, subhanAllah. But all the time, we remember the worldly thing, $10, $20, we remember that. If you lose, we say, why I lose $20? But the reward of Jumah prayer, reward of fasting, reward of dhikr, going automatically from you, but you do not care about that. Also, there are a few things which we do, which we talk about some things, and that won't be counted from the backbiting. That won't be counted from the backbiting. Inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, we will talk about that our next Jum'ah prayer, bi'ithnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make us from those who learn Quran and Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and act upon it and pass it to others. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, by His mercy, make us from those who is acting upon the Quran, who is acting upon the Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, by His mercy, make us all Muslim united, inshaAllah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Make us from those who are hand to hand helping each other, brother and sister to each other. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala give a lot of rewards to those brothers and sisters who built Masjid As-Salam wa ma alayya illa al-balagh al-mubin. Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'hdih. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد النبي الرسول أما بعد عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ بنفسه أولا وثنى بملائكته وثلث بكم أيها المؤمنون فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم كن معهم ولا تكن عليهم يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم انصرهم على أعدائك وأعداء الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصرهم نصر عاجل غير آجل يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اجعل المسلمين مؤمنين حقا اللهم اجعل المسلمين من الذين يعتصمون بحبلك المتين وبسنة نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اهدنا صراطك المستقيم صراط الأنبياء والشهداء والصديقين والصالحين اللهم باعدنا والمسلمين والمسلمات جميعا من صراط اليهود والنصارى يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم اجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع صدورنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا وغمومنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعله شفيعا لنا يوم القيامة يا أرحم الراحمين المؤمنين وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون واذكروا الله تعالى الكريم الجليل يذكركم ولذكر الله تعالى أولى وعز وجل وأتم والله تعالى يعلم ما تصنعون
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا
الله رسول الله برزة أولياء قوم محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم he mentioned whoever prays janazah prayer whoever prays janazah prayer Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will give him reward of one qirat. What is one qirat? Qirat is equal to the huge mountain or a mountain of Uhud which is in Medina al-Munawwara. One mountain is tons and tons and tons of waves. SubhanAllah, would you like brothers and sisters to get that reward today inshallah?
Inshallah.
One of our Muslim brother from Indonesia, he passed away today. And our brothers, may Allah reward them all, the Sheikh Abu Abdullah, gave him ghusl and kafan and brought him here. Janazah is outside. What we'll do, inshallah, let's pray our sunnah. Sunnah quickly, inshallah. After sunnah, we'll bring the body here, inshallah, the dead body here. We will pray janazah and give the reward. And afterwards, if you want to add another qirat, another huge reward, we will go down to cemetery, inshallah. Bearing him, that is the right of that brother which is already passed away. Brothers, stay back, inshallah, tabaraka ta'ala. That won't take us, inshallah, more than 10 minutes. Jazakumullah khairan. In 10 minutes, you get the mountain rewards, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. Brothers, inshallah, you go to the graveyard.
Down, 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 down